Welcome to the Digital Bindery web series, Ebooks, How Do They Work? This video will discuss the ebook Mimetype file in a very simple way and how to use that knowledge to continue to format your ebooks on your own terms. Our last video discussed how to unpack your automatically converted EPUB and MOBI files to find the three special files inside. The two folders, meta-inf and OEBPS, and the file Mimetype. Now we will focus on the Mimetype file. In order to follow every step in this video, you will need a plain text editor. Your operating system most likely came with one installed, like Notepad or TextEdit, and those will be just fine. Others include TextWrangler, Notepad 2, or VI. First, some background. MIME stands for Multimedia Internet Mail Extensions. As its name suggests, MIME was originally developed as a mechanism for transmitting internet mail. Long, long ago, in 1991, email was only text and could only utilize English characters. As the demand for utility grew and technology responded, email became more complex. In 1992, the Internet Engineering Task Force developed MIME as a way for email applications to identify what kind of files they were sent. The applications could then know how to process the information. As the internet in general became more complex, HTML adopted the protocol so web browsers could identify web content. MIME is now a generic term that identifies the content type of a particular file. Think of the Mimetype file as the "Hello, my name is" sticker of the ebook. Remember the last convention you went to? Your name badge said something like, "Hello, my name is Amanda, and I am an ebook goddess." When you met new people, they could look at your badge and know what you liked to be called and what type of business you were in. The Mimetype file is the first file that your e-reading software encounters. The Mimetype says, "Hello, my name is Ebook, and I am an EPUB or MOBI, as the case may be." The Mimetype is a very short line of text. The file itself is not as complicated as a Microsoft Word or OpenOffice document. It is more like the very simple .txt files you can create with a plain text editor like Notepad or TextEdit. If you right-click for PC or control-click for Mac and select Open with one of these programs, you will see that it opens easily. Inside the file, it is very important that only one of three things are written. Either application/epub+zip, application/x-mobipocket-ebook, or application/octet-stream. This is the precise code that is needed to tell the e-reading software that your group of files is an ebook and that it is an EPUB, a MOBI, or an AZW type of file. The important thing to remember is that this is all the file should say. If it says anything else, the ebook will not function. EPUB checking software and e-reading devices are so sensitive to the syntax that even adding an extra space before or after this code snippet can, and often does, result in catastrophic failure. Because of the delicate nature of this file, unless your validation software returns an error indicating a problem with the Mimetype, there is no need to open the file or modify it in any way. Like the "Hello, my name is" sticker that loses its stick the more you rip it off and put it back on, the less you fiddle with the Mimetype, the better it will be. The final two things to note about the Mimetype file are that it must be the first file that your e-reading software encounters, and it must be uncompressed. If we go back to our "Hello, my name is" analogy, we can see how useless the sticker would become if it were folded up to save space or in one of your pockets. No one would know what to call you or what you did. The same is true with the Mimetype file. The e-reader will not bother to look for the information or ask the file if it's got it hidden under its blazer. The e-reader will simply reject the file as an unknown format, and your book will not be displayed. All this means is that when you are reassembling your ebook after you have fixed any errors, you must use archiving software that allows you to control your file order and individual file compression. We will discuss this in more detail in a later video. Stay tuned for the next episode of Digital Bindery's web series, Ebooks, How Do They Work?, in which we will examine such mysteries as style sheets, metadata, and recompiling. If you have any questions or would like to suggest a future episode in this series, you can contact me at amanda@digitalbindery.com.